Hello, everyone. My name is Andrew Oberle, and I'm here to share with you my experience with SSM Health Community as a patient. That experience has helped me discover renewed life purpose in my life and has inspired me to carry on that spirit of community that makes SSM Health so extraordinary. In June of 2012, I was conducting my master's research in anthropology at a chimpanzee sanctuary in South Africa. Going to Africa and working with chimps had been a passion of mine since I was around 8 years old. But little did I know that one afternoon, my passion would almost kill me. While most think chimps are cute and cuddly like they are in this picture, which they are until around age 6, they're also wild animals. Full-grown adult males are incredibly dangerous and are considered one of the most aggressive animals in the world. When adolescent development kicks in, by 10 to 12 years, these cute, cuddly guys you see on TV turn into 4-foot-tall, 200-pound juggernauts with razor-sharp teeth and the strength of 5 men. They can be very powerful, very dangerous animals. Now, regardless of the impetus that caused their rage, the two chimps saw me as a threat and escaped their enclosure that day to teach me a deadly lesson. I really remember almost every terrifying moment of the attack. I screamed and I pleaded. While they held me down, they bit me, they tore at my flesh. Nikki, Amadeus, please stop. If I close my eyes, I can really still feel Nikki's hot breath on my face right before he bit my nose. And I feel the crunch in the back of my head when Amadeus took a nice chunk out of my occipital bun, the bone at the back of my skull. Needless to say, these guys nearly killed me. When the sanctuary employees finally got the chimps away, I was rushed to a small emergency med clinic in pretty dire condition. The chimps, they took parts of my scalp, my nose, my ears, a little bit of my skull, most of my fingers, half of my right foot, all the toes on my left foot. They destroyed my right wrist. They put a paralyzing gash on my face. They collapsed my lung, took several more chunks out of my abdomen, my buttocks, my legs. In my first surgery alone, I needed 22 units of blood. I had acute respiratory distress syndrome and went into septic shock several times. When the doctors finally got in touch with my mom, they basically told her, get to South Africa as quickly as possible, but don't have your hopes up. They put me in an induced coma for about 3.5 weeks, had me on a ventilator for over a month. Since that day, I've had 25 surgeries. The last of those was actually just 2 weeks ago, and countless hours of rehabilitative therapies. But I survived, and as my mentor says, my life since that day has been a miracle that keeps moving. Surviving, of course, was miraculous, but it didn't stop there. A few days after the attack, Helen, an SSM Health St. Louis University Hospital nurse and administrator, received a call from her good friend Joanne, who just happens to be my uncle's stepmom. That small connection would save my life and bring me home. Helen immediately took action and adamantly made my case to those in charge, saying that if I didn't make it to SLU Hospital, I wouldn't survive. With that, she secured my fate and brought me home. A young man, no health insurance, and probably over $1 million worth of care needed. I had never met this woman, and yet she was doing everything in her power to bring me home alive and set me up for world-class care. More importantly, Helen really became a second mom to me. She brought me delicious food to fatten me up every day. She told me every day how proud she was of me. She gave my mangled cheek kisses, made sure I had everything I needed to heal and to thrive, and embraced me really the only way a mom can. Without Helen, I can say with strong confidence that I would have died in that hospital in South Africa. My family, my friends, and I owe everything to her. However, the miracle didn't stop moving there. Knowing I would need daily home health care after getting out of the hospital, Helen asked her longtime friend and colleague, Tony McNeese, if he could help out. Like Helen, he immediately took action. He came to my house almost every day, sometimes twice a day, just to care for me. He changed my dressings, watched for infections, and even eventually helped me shower. More importantly, though, he became my best friend during a time I really needed that most. He helped me cope with everything that I had gone through and was still going through. Tony really helped me regain my love for life at a time when that fire was really almost extinguished. I can say without Tony, yeah, I'd still be alive, but I definitely would not be thriving like I am today. But again, the miracle didn't stop moving. In bringing me to St. Louis University Hospital, Helen immediately made me part of the SLU community. She first reached out to St. Louis University Dr. Bruce Kramer, Chief of Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery, and asked if he could put me back together. He enthusiastically agreed, arranged an interdisciplinary team, and started me on my healing journey. As I was going through surgeries and rehab, I quickly learned that on top of the amazing care I was receiving, something much more important was happening. I started to realize that all these people surrounding me, Dr. Kramer, Helen, Tony, everybody, actually sincerely cared about me. It wasn't just my doctors, my nurses, or my therapists, but also even just the valet folks that would park my car at the doctor's office building, or the woman who checked me in at those appointments, or even the OR administrator, and just many, many more that I could sit here and keep you here till 8 o'clock tonight to talk about. Every day I came to campus, my spirit was healed just a little more as all these amazing people asked me how I was doing, told me I was looking great, and that they were bursting with pride watching my daily progress. I mean, how can you feel so down when so many people are lifting you up? The importance of this community in my life is immeasurable, not only because it saved my life, but also because through caring for me, this community has given me the opportunity and the passion to take what happened to me and turn it around to help others. Just over a year ago, St. Louis University asked me to join their medical center development team to use my experience, share my story, to develop a comprehensive interdisciplinary center of excellence to treat those who've experienced traumatic injury or illness. The result is the Center for Innovative Reconstruction and Rehabilitation. I've been there for about 10 months now, sharing my story and rallying expert faculty and staff from over a dozen different departments at St. Louis University and SSM Health St. Louis University Hospital to join this center and help us provide comprehensive rehabilitation and reconstruction to those who've experienced traumatic injury or illness in order to rebuild bodies, minds, and spirits to regain independent lives and renewed life purpose. We're still in the development stages, but once we officially open, we'll be able to help others get through their trauma the way SSM SLU has helped me. Our goal is to help others not only survive, but thrive by inviting each patient to be a part of our community and experience the spirit-lifting and life-changing power of healing that only SSM Health can offer. I just wanted to say I'm honored to have one of the most important people in my life here with me, not just in my medical journey, but in my life altogether. Helen, if you're back there, if you want to maybe come join me up here. Yeah, she deserves it, guys. Without Helen, I wouldn't be here. Sorry to make you walk so far, Helen. But any chance I can get a hug, I'll take it. And that's all I got. Thank you, guys.